Okay, let us start the class. Today we will see the star delta networks. Today we will discuss the topic star delta conversion. How to convert the star network to delta network and delta network to star network. Star can also be represented as Y. Y or star. How to convert the star network to delta, again from delta to star. Then, what is the purpose of converting this star to delta and delta to star? The purpose is to simplify the network. The rider, star delta conversion. Siding, star delta conversion. This is the symbol for star. Star can also be called as Y. And this is delta. Mainly for simplification of the networks, we go for the star to delta conversion. In complicated networks, suppose if you are not able to solve the problem, then this conversion will be useful. Now we'll see what is star. See here. This is the star connection. One center point is there, or Y connection. Star or Y connection. Let us take this is center point. To this center point, this is one branch, this is another branch, this is another branch. This is of the Y type. Y type is called star connection. Okay. Let us take R1, R2, and R3. We are having three resistors in the star connection. Now I am assuming R1 is equal to 1 ohm, R2 is equal to 2 ohms, R3 is equal to 3 ohms. I am taking the values. Now I know the values of R1, R2 and R3. Now I have to convert this star connection to delta connection. How to convert this? So your delta is, let us take, this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay. I'm taking the point, this, I'm center point is generally limited. See this other end, this is one branch. One end is connected to center point. The other end is point A. Here also, this branch. One end is connected to center, the other end is B. Here, center, the other end is C. Now, how to convert this star to delta? Now, join this A and B. Let us take R, A, B. Okay. Now, B and C. Join B and C. This is R, B, C. Join C and A. This is R, C, A. R, A, B, B, C and C, A. Now if you redraw this, see here, we'll get the delta. This is A, B, C. In between R, this is R, A, B. This is R, B, C. This is R, C. See, this is the delta connection. So, I know the values of star connection, R1, R2, R3. But I don't know the values of this delta connected values. I don't know the resistance of these values. I know the values of star connection, R1, R2, and R3. Now, how to convert this star to delta? See here. I am taking numerator and denominator. Numerator and denominator. Now, how to get the value of RAB? Now, see here, this R1 is connected to this R1 is connected to point A. Listen here, this R1 is connected to point A. this point A is connected to this point. Sorry, let us take RAB. Sorry, I am telling you now. This is RAB. See, I want to determine RAB. This RAB is connected to A and B. This RAB is connected to this vertex and this vertex. That means this RAB is connected to R1 and R3. But this RAB is not connected to which resistor?
R2.
This R2 I am keeping here. Now take RBC. RBC is connected to R2 and R3, but it is not connected to
R1.
Next, RCA, R1, R2, but it is not connected to R3. Now it is clear. Denominator part is clear. Okay. So we have to see the delta value, RA, which is connected to these two. It is not connected to R3. Now in the numerator, what I will do is, I will take the, first I will write, then I will explain. This is R1, R2, plus R2, R3. Plus R3, R1. See here, I am taking the product.
Is it visible? Okay.
Now R1, R1, R2. First I am multiplying R1, R2. Plus R2, R3. Plus R3, R1. Here the product. Sum. First I am taking sum. This is plus means sum. Sum of product of adjacent branches. See what are adjacent? R1, R2 are adjacent. Product of adjacent branches, R2, R3, adjacent branch product, R3, R1, adjacent branch product, sum of product of adjacent branches, right? RAB is equal to, right? RAB is equal to sum of product of adjacent branches of star collection. Numerator, what you will write? Right? Sum of product of sum, SEM sum, sum of product of adjacent branches of star connection. Sum of product of adjacent branches of star connection divided by resistance which is not connected. Resistance which is not connected divided by resistance which is not connected to RAB. Resistance which is not connected to RAB. Is it clear? Now I know the values of star connection R1, R2, R3. Now see here, same form, same numerator, numerator value will be same. Same numerator, R1, R2 plus R2, R3 plus R3, R1. Here also, R1, R2 plus R2, R3 plus R3, R1. Numerator part is same, but denominator will change. If you want to convert the star to delta network, these are the formulas. Numerator part will be same. Numerator what you write, sum of product of adjacent branches of star connection divided by resistance which is not connected to this branch. Resistance which is not connected to this branch. Resistance which is not connected to this branch. Now, substitute the values. R1 we know. R1 is 1 ohm. R2 is 2 ohm. R3 is 3 ohm. Now tell me the values of RAB, RBC and RCA. Tell me the values. Take your calculators. Calculator should be compulsorily with you when you are attending the class.
RAB 5.5
5.511
5.511 3.66
5.511
3.66
These are the values. Now I have converted star connection to delta. Now I will convert this delta to star again now. Then what are the formulas? We will see that. If you have completed this, we will go for now delta. Delta value is right here. 5.5. Then RBC is 11. This is 3.66. RCS 3.66. Draw this diagram and write down the place. This is the delta connection. Now I will convert this delta to star. For converting delta to star, what you have to do is we have to take the center point. For converting, right on setting delta to star. For converting delta to star, take the center point in delta. Take the center point in delta. See here, how we'll get one vertex? In between two resistors, I'll get one vertex. In between these two, I'll get one vertex. In between these two, I'll get one vertex. In between these two, I'll get one vertex. Three vertexes are there. 1, 2, 3. Now from the center point, join to all the vertices. Three vertices, 1, 2, 3. I am joining three vertices. Now I am assuming this one as R1. This is R2. This will be R3. Same thing what you have taken in star. This is R1, R2 and R3. Okay. Now see here. Now I know the values of delta. I don't know R1, R2, R3. No. I had to determine R1, R2, and R3. See the formulas. R1, R2, R3. Now see here. Numerator is same, but here denominator will be same. Denominator is RAB. Plus RBC plus RCA. Here denominator is same. There, while converting star to delta, numerator is same. But here, what is denominator? Sum of resistances of all delta connections. Sum of resistances of delta connections. Three resistances are there in delta: RAB, RBC, and RCA. Sum of resistances of delta connection. Denominator. Then what is numerator part? Denominator is same for R1, R2 and R3. Now what is numerator? See, R1 is connected to this vertex. R1 is connected to this vertex. To this vertex, what are the adjacent branches? To point A, what are the adjacent branches?
C and D.
C and R. RCA into RAB. Point. R1 is connected to vertex A. These two are adjacent branches. Product of adjacent branch resistances of this vertex. Now R2. R2, what are the adjacent branches?
CARAB.
And BC. C, these two are adjacent branches for R2. Now come to R3.
RAB, RBC.
Okay. RAB, RBC. Now I know the values of RAB, RBC and RCA. Substitute here. Denominator will be same. Now write down the formula. R1 is equal to product of adjacent branches of this vertex. Product of adjacent branches of R1 connected vertex. Product of adjacent branches of R1 connected vertex. Product of numerator, product of adjacent branches of R1 connected vertex, of R1 connected vertex, divided by sum of resistances of delta connection, sum of resistances of delta connection, sum of resistances of delta connection, sum of resistances of delta connection. See here, denominator will be same, but here numerator is same. What is the difference? Now you will get R1 is equal to, calculate and tell me the values, substitute the values here. You have to get 1, 2, 3. Answers are 1, 2, 3. Calculate and see. See the star connection. At the beginning of the class, we have taken star network. The same values we have converted star to delta. 1, 2, 3 is converted. The same values will be there. When you are converting, 1, 2, 3 we have converted to delta values. Again, delta values are converted to star. 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. We have to get the same values. In this way, we will convert star to delta and delta network to star network. The purpose of conversion is only to simplify the network. For simplification of the network, we will use this method for complicated networks. We'll see some examples so that you can understand. Take one example. Determine the resistance in between terminals A and B. Using star delta conversion. So how many delta networks are there inside this network?
Two
delta networks. See here, this is one delta, this is another delta. For simplification, what in the problem, what he is asking us to determine, instead of all the resistances, they are asking only one resistance to convert this all resistance into single resistance in between A and B. In between A and B. That is RAB. RAB is the resistance. So I want to determine only one resistance by combining all these resistances. Now here the upper one is 1 delta. See three resistors, 4, 5, 2 is 1 delta. 2, 1 and 3 is another delta. 2, 1 and 3 is another delta. Now let us take any 1 delta connection and convert it to star. Don't take both. Either upper delta connection you can convert it to star for simplification, or lower delta can be converted to star for simplification. Which one do you want?
Upper.
Upper, okay. See here, I'm taking the center point for converting delta to star. In between these two resistances, one vertex is there. Let us take, okay. In between these two resistances, another vertex is there. 1, 2. In between 2 and 4, one vertex is there. In between 2 and 4, one vertex. Total 3 vertices. One vertex will come in between two resistances. Between these two. Now join all these vertexes. Now name these resistances. Let us take this is R1, R2. And R3. You can take this one also R2, no problem. R1, R2 and R3 I think. Write on this. Now I want to, I know the values of delta. Now I want to convert it to star. See here. Now I am determining R1, R2, R3. R1, R2, R3. What is R1? R1 is connected to this vertex. What will you get in the numerator? What are the adjacent branches for this vertex? 4 and?
5.
4 and 5. For R2, what are the adjacent branches?
5 and 2.
5 and 2. For R3, what are the adjacent branches?
4 and 2.
4 and 2. Okay. Product of adjacent branches of the delta. This R1 is connected to this. See only delta connection. Don't see all the resistances. What are the delta connection? 4, 5 and 2. 4 and 5. R1 is connected to 4 and 5. R2 is connected to 5 and 2. R3 is connected to 4 and 2. In the denominator, 2 plus 4 plus 5. Sum of all resistances of delta connection. 2 plus 4 plus 5. What is R1?
1.81.
R2?
0.90.
0.90?
0.
Okay. R3?
0.72.
72. Okay. Now what we'll do is draw one more. Now remove this delta values. Because we have converted the delta to star. Now remove this delta values. Draw this network. Remove this delta and draw this network. Draw one more network, this one. Thank you.
Have you drawn?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Now see here. This R2 and 1 are in series. These two resistances are in series. Instead of two resistors, I am pressing it only one resistance. 1 plus 0.9. This is 1.9. 1 plus 0.9. Series. In series, you can add resistances. R3 and these three are in series. That is 3.7. Instead of two resistors, I am writing only one resistance. 3 plus 0.7. That is 3.7. Now see here, 1 and R1 are in series. What is the value of 1 plus 1.81? That is 2.81. In series, you can add the resistances. These two are in series. I keep one resistance. Draw the circuit. I am simplifying the rectangle. Now 1.9 and 3.72 are in parallel. R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Simplify these two. These two are parallel. Convert into single resistance. R1 R2 by R1 plus R2.
7.4.
How much?
7.4.
Now I am removing this resistance. Parallel combination. Now I am keeping only one resistance here. 7.44 ohms. Now RAB. R are in series. In series, we'll add all these resistances. 2.81 plus 7.44 plus 3. This is the value of resistance R.
How much is it?
13.25 ohms.
So in this way we determine resistance, single resistance. If you are not able, if you are not applying star delta conversion or delta to star conversion, we can't simplify this network. So for simplification of the networks, we'll go for the star delta conversions. We'll see one more example. Determine the current in 10 ohms.
Determine the current in 10 ohms. Using star delta conversion. Determine the current in 10 ohms using star delta conversion. Okay, have you drawn the circuit?
Listen here. 8 and 4 are in series or parallel? In series, we can add the resistances. That means 8 plus 4 is 12. Similarly, here 17 and 13 are in series. 17 plus 13?
30.
Now, this is one delta connection. This is another delta connection. Now, convert this delta to star. And convert this delta to star. Okay. All are equal values here. 12, 12, 12. See here. I am connecting to this vertex, to this vertex, to this vertex. R1, R2, R3. R1, 12 into 12. Divided by sum of delta values, 12 plus 12 plus 12. We'll get same value here also for R2, 12 into 12 divided by 12 plus 12. Same values in here, because in delta same values are there for R1, R2 is equal to R2. How much? That means R2 is also 36. R3 is also 36. All are same because same values delta. If same values are delta, we'll get same values R1, R2 and R. Here also 12 into 12 divided by this one. 12 into 12 divided by this one. Okay. Now what you have to do is now remove this.
Sir, R1 4, sir, not 36.
This one? 4? Then R3 is also 4. Okay. Now remove this delta here. Similarly, here also. Same form. Let us take same values are there for delta. Let us take R1 is equal to 30 into 30 by 30 plus 30 plus 30. It will be 10 ohms. R1 is 10, R2 is 10, R3 is 10. I have converted. Now remove this delta. After converting star to delta, we have to remove the delta connection. There should not be any delta connection. Here also. R1 is 4, R3 is 4, R3 is 4. draw this diagram.
After converting delta to star, you have to remove the delta connection. You have to place only star connection. Have you drawn?
Here, this four that four 34 and 10 are in series. 34 plus 4, 38. 38 plus 10, 48. Now see here, this 4 and 10, this is one branch. From here to here, this is one branch. 10 and 4 are in series or parallel? This 4, this is only one branch from here, see? In same branch, if you are having resistance, these two are in series. This is only one branch. In the same branch you are having 10 and 4. That will be 10 plus 4 is 14.
14.
This is 14. Now see here, in which branch he is asking the current in this 10 ohm. He is asking the current in this 10 ohm. That means in this branch, he is asking us to determine the current. 10 plus 4 plus 10, 24. This entire branch is 24. Remember that in 10 ohms, whatever the current flowing in 10, the same current will flow in 4 ohms and 10 ohms also in the same branch. Now I want to determine the current in 24 ohms. The current in 24 ohm is nothing but current in 10 ohms. So don't forget the branch where he is asking us to determine the current. In this branch he is asking. So the current in 4 ohms is equal to current in 10 ohms is equal to current in 10 ohms. Because in the series current will be same. Whatever the current flowing in this 10 ohm, the same current will flow in this entire branch. That means I want to determine the current in 24 ohms. That is the current in 10 ohms. Okay. Now see here. Which method will apply for determining the current in this? We can apply any method, mesh analysis, nodal analysis, current divide rule, anything we can apply. But we should not disturb this branch. In this branch, I have to determine the current. Which method can you apply? How many nodes are there? How many nodes are there? Anyone?
One
node is there. There is only one node.
So in your textbook, they have given the answer in this 10 ohms is 4 ampere.
We'll verify whether you get this answer or not. Okay. In your textbook, current in 10 ohms, they are giving us 4 ampere. We'll see whether you get the answer. Now see here, there is only one node. This is the node. This is the reference node, 0 volts. Otherwise, we can take it as 0 volts. We can take this node also, V1. Let us assume V1 is the voltage. I am applying node analysis. V1 is the voltage. Okay. I want to determine the current in this branch, not in this branch. Okay. Now see, assume all the currents are leaving from this node point. Our assumption in node analysis is this one. So V1 minus 0 divided V1 minus 180 minus 0 divided by 14. This arrow is completed. Now come to this arrow. V1 minus 0 by 48 plus V1 minus 0 by 24. Now determine V1 from this.
Ninety-six point six one volts.
But I want the current in 24. That is, let us take current flowing in. This is I. Okay. I want the current in 10 ohms. Current in 10 ohms is equal to current in 24 ohms. That is, current is equal to I is equal to V1 minus 0 by 24. That is 96.61 divided by 24. We will get 4 ampere. In the textbook also, they have given the same answer, 4 ampere. That is the current in 10 ohms. So, in this way, we will solve the complicated networks by using star delta conversion. Go through the problems what you had discussed today, star delta conversion. Meanwhile, I will take the attendance.